The 1.2-liter turbo engine in Vauxhall and Opel cars is actually the Peugeot EB2DTS engine. Exactly the same engine is used in the Opel and Vauxhall Corsa F, Opel and Vauxhall Grandland X, and also Peugeot 208, Peugeot 308 and Citroën C4. The slightly different variations of this engine are also used in tons of other European cars that have connections with the Peugeot Citroën group. So they are very popular and there are a lot of these engines on the road. By the way, the engine was engineered back in 2014, so it's not that fresh. So this is the 1.2-liter 3-cylinder turbocharged engine with direct injection, the belt-driven timing system and additional balance shafts in the block. The timing belt is wet, which means it's located inside the engine and is submerged in oil bath. I will cover this a little later in the problems section. The engine has a dual VTI valve timing system for efficiency and economy. One more interesting thing is that the engine doesn't have the valve lifters and you will have to adjust the valve clearance once every several years. Interestingly, even in the Grandland X, the engine shows a pretty good dynamic with its 130 horsepower. But the power is less important than torque, which is pretty high here at 240 Nm. Also, the engines are known for extremely good fuel economy. The average combined city highway consumption is 5.5 liters per 100 km or 51 mpg-UK. Well, it's close to impossible to achieve these claimed figures in real life, but still, it's very impressive for an SUV. So when it comes to lifespan, these engines are claimed to last about 250,000 km till you have first expensive repairs. This is an average estimated lifespan, so some will drive these engines longer, while others may replace them at a lower mileage. Opel and Vauxhall started using this engine in 2017, so they avoided having a bunch of initial problems. Earlier engine models had issues with blocks and crankshafts, but Peugeot fixed them pretty quickly. One of the problems is the carbon buildup on intake valves, because this is the direct injection engine and fuel doesn't travel through the valves, it's directly injected into the cylinders. Usually the vehicles that I use mainly in city traffic have carbon buildup issues after 50-60,000 km and require professional cleaning. One more issue is the oil consumption that starts bothering owners at about 100,000 km. This means that oil rings on the pistons and valve seals start leaking a little oil into the combustion chambers. While this is a relatively serious problem, there is nothing you can do to prevent it. And fixing this issue will cost you a fortune, so owners usually keep adding oil and driving further. Now you should keep an eye on the oil level, because these engines won't last even a single day with critically low oil pressure. But the worst issue is the wet belt construction. This is probably the worst timing system in the world of internal combustion engines. The belt is pretty hard to replace, that's why labor costs are insane. The manufacturer says it will last 180,000 km, but it doesn't last that much. While the belt most likely won't break and destroy the engine, it will start falling apart and contaminating your oil. The parts of the belt material will travel to the filter, and when the filter is clogged, they will also be accumulated in the oil pump. At 180,000 km, when it's time to change the belt, it's usually too late and the engine already suffers from poor oil pressure. You can avoid this, and I strongly recommend replacing the entire belt kit and cleaning the oil pump at about 100,000 km or 6 years, whatever comes first. And of course, you should only use the OEM kits. They aren't that expensive, but the labor will be expensive, so there is no reason to save several euros on the belt and compromise quality. Overall, this is a well-engineered engine with only one very serious problem with the wet timing belt. Other than that, it's pretty good to drive, very economical, and also relatively cheap to maintain and repair.